Welcome back to All Things Gumball, and thank you again for subscribing to this website. I know that all of you guys that are on this website, I'm believing, found me through the YouTube avenue, and I really do want to say thank you for subscribing, and thank you for giving positive feedback to all the videos that I've been producing. Just so you know, it does take a bit of time to think of new ideas that I haven't talked about and edit the videos and produce the videos with other things that I'm working on. Working on my vending business and spending time with friends and family and just basically doing things that normal people do, like watch movies and television shows and YouTube channels. You know, I love learning new things, so I'm always watching things on YouTube. So what do we talk about today? Let's talk about hiring somebody. Now, as you know, your business is cash. I can't even talk. Your business is a cash business. So you are going to be dealing with people that have maybe a desire, maybe a temptation to steal money from your vending machines. If you have someone that's running the route for you, they could take a dollar from every machine. They could take four quarters from every machine that they service. And if they service 20 in a day, well, that's $20 a day. And if they work 5 days a week for you, they could steal $100 from you, and that would be $400 a month. And you may not even know it. So if you're going to hire somebody, make sure that you hire somebody that you really trust. I thought to myself, if I hired somebody that I really care about, for example, my brother, and if he stole from me, I don't think I would feel too bad because it's my brother and I know the money is going to help him or help his family. You know, he has a child, you know, so I took a little break, had a drink of water, and I actually spilled some water on my shirt. I don't know if you can see it. I don't know if it looks wet or not. But, okay, so I was talking about hiring somebody. So as I've mentioned in other videos, you've got three jobs in the vending business. You've got the first job, which is the most enjoyable, and that's going around and collecting the quarters and taking the money. Who doesn't love money, right? You know, putting the quarters in the bank and putting the candy in the machine, visiting with the people where the vending machines are located. That's probably the first part of the job that everyone likes. The second part of that job is finding locations. And that's probably the part of the job that nobody likes. I mean, because you get a lot of people that say no to you when you go and ask them if they can let you put a vending machine in their store. 9 out of 10 will say no to you. So when you're making cold calls over the phone, 20 will say no, 15 to 20 will say no, and then one will say yes on the phone. And then the third part of the business is doing what I'm doing right here. I'm actually sanding down these rusty bases because they sit in water when people mop the floors. I don't think people really know how to wring out a mop very well, and so they have a very wet floor and they just leave the vending machine in a wet floor. And so these have gotten rusty, so I'm actually sanding these down. I'm going to repaint them. So let's say you want to hire somebody, but you don't really trust that they won't steal from you. What do? You could hire them to help you clean the machines. And if you have too many machines like myself, and I've hired people to help me, what do? Well, when I first started this, when I first started hiring people to help me out, what I would do is I would just let them go. Just, you know, tell them where everything is, the tools, the parts, you know. And I would just let them go, and I'd go out and check machines, and then I'd come back 6, 7, 8 hours later and see what they did. And a lot of times they might have 1 or 2 machines ready and clean, ready to go for the, you know, for the next time I go out looking for locations. And I thought, I'm paying this guy, you know, 10 bucks an hour, and I'm paying him roughly $100 to get 2 machines ready. Well, I could buy 2 machines for $100. So I think what you need to do is you need to just line up like 100 things for that person to do. Like, for an example, line up 25 canisters that need to be clean and assembled. And like these bases here that you've seen me working on, line up 10 of these and say all of these need to be sanded down and give them a chore, not just let them go sporadically. And then one of the things that I found is one of the guys that I was working with, he was fairly slow. He was just very slow moving. And he would probably do one or two machines a day. And that would be an 8-hour job. And he'd get one or two machines ready. And I think what I found out that works better for him is I just say, I'll pay you by the piece, you know, by the part, by the machine. So you get one machine ready, I'll pay you $25. So that seems to work best for me. So find somebody that is either very fast and very good, organized at what they're doing, or if they're not, if they're really slow and they poke along, just pay them by the piece, you know. All right, so I hope that helps you with your vending business. I don't know if you're big enough to have people that you need to hire at this moment, but maybe one day you will. I will catch you on another video. Have a good evening, have a good morning, or have a good afternoon.